Hello friends, welcome to Share Market Friend again. Today I am going to talk about one of the concept related to investment, or I am going to share my understanding related to one concept of investment, that is inflation, impact of inflation on our investment, and I will going to explain it with one simple example. Basically, I want to set the base for it first. Every person who is earning money, who is living a normal life, or who is surviving a life in society, he always saves some money. Some saves per month 1,000, some saves, some people save 100 rupees, some rich people may save 1 lakh rupee per month, or somebody may save 1 crore per month, depending on their earning ability. So when they are saving their money, they may invest in fixed deposit, they may save in the form of cash, they may save in the gold or commodity kind of things, they may invest in land, etc., where they expect a rise in their base money or base investment. So whenever we do such investment, we expect or we think that simply calculate it with simple compound interest calculation, that if we calculate it with 8% of interest rate, that is, I am assuming of average 8% for 10 years duration. So if you invest 1 lakh rupees for 8% FD, or you can get same around 8 to 10% return in any other investment avenues, something. So if you invest 1 lakh rupees at an interest rate of 8% in FD kind of thing, then after 10 years, you will get at a compound interest of 8%, 2,21,000. So that is like simply doubling your money from 1 lakh to 2 lakh. But in this calculation, there is one flaw. Whenever you go for any investment advisor or any person who is selling you some investment tool kind of thing, he will simply show you this thing, that is, your 1 lakh or your per month investment, that is amounting to 1 lakh per year for 10 years. If you do in this particular plan, in this insurance kind of thing, etc., it will convert into 2,21,000 at the end of 10 years. So it is a basic example, I am assuming. But in this calculation, there is one flaw, that is the inflation, that is rising costs of the thing, that is simply neglected, or people neglect it. I think that is the most important thing that drives people to equity and other avenues of investment other than fixed deposit. Let's see how it impacts your investment. So for that, I'll need to explain that. Suppose if you're buying a pen that is 10 rupees or 100 rupees good pen, so do you think that it will cost at 100 rupees in the next year also, or year after next year, after 5 years, it will cost 100 rupees? No, the simple answer is no. It will definitely cost more, or it will be costlier compared to the today's price. The price of pen may become 100 rupees to 200, it may become 100 rupees to 110, 120, etc. In rare cases like electronics, etc., where their prices get reduced or specification increases, but most of the things like daily living things like shoes, bottles, electronic things, etc., which we use daily, TV, etc., and all other glass, construction material, etc., that goes on inflating every year. Those price goes on increasing every year. So whatever you will be buying with 2,21,000, just because of 6% inflation, that will also compound itself, because every year it will be compounding on last year's price. So it will make your overall investment worth 1,23,000. So this is a simple but important thing we need to understand, that your investment may look like 2,21,000, its cost will look like 2,21,000, but compared to 10 years back prices, it will buy only 1,23,000 rupees things after 10 years. So whatever things you are buying for 2,21,000, you won't get same after 10 years. So this 2,21,000 things buying capacity is only before 10 years, but after 10 years, your worth of overall investment will be actually 1,23,000. So I hope you understand this concept. You can extend this concept to more increasing amount, like 10 lakh will get converted with 8% interest rate to 22 lakh something, or it may change slightly. basic calculation I have done, not up to accurate decimals, etc. So 10 lakh will get converted to 22 lakh, but it will look 22 lakh, but after 10 years its worth or its buying power in the market will be only 12 lakh if you are considering for 10 lakh. So I hope you understand that whenever you are assuming that your 1 lakh saving currently, whatever you have, it is going to get converted to 2,21,000, but actually it is increasing by just 23%, or in the range of 20 to 25%. It is not going to get double or more than double. Its cost just appear double, but its worth is not going to get double that way. So what is the solution for this? What is the solution for things getting costly? What is the solution for inflation? So how to beat inflation? So basically there are many ways what I think we can pursue to beat inflation, like investing for long term in equity, though it can give you return in long term in the range of 15 to 20%. That can beat your inflation, but it doesn't guarantee. That is the main flaw of equity. Or you can invest in various investment avenues, like doing business or buying land, buying home, etc. That also carries risk of business or market value in itself. So even if you don't beat it, even if you don't do business, even if you don't go aggressive in equity, but you need to understand this concept that your 1 lakh is not going to be 2,21,000 after 10 years. It is actually going to be worth only 23% more, that is 1,23,000. And accordingly that you have to increase your basic investment. You have to understand this. You have to prepare yourself that inflation is going to beat you in long term. So that was all about impact of inflation or overall investing thing that I wanted to explain. I hope you must have understood this concept. If you like this video, you can click on like and subscribe to my channel, Share Market Friend. Thank you for listening, Share Market Friend.